You're listening to an archived Cabral Concept podcast. After listening to this show, check out the most up-to-date podcasts available at stephencabral.com/podcasts or search directly on iTunes. And now, welcome to the Cabral Concept, where board-certified naturopath and integrative health practitioner Dr. Stephen Cabral shares how he was diagnosed at the age of 17 with a life-altering illness and given no hope for recovery. It was only after studying and traveling all over the world did he discover how to combine ancient Ayurvedic healing practices with state-of-the-art naturopathic and functional medicine to fully rebalance the body and re-energize it with life. It's time to discover how to get well, lose weight, and finally feel alive again. And now, here's your host, Dr. Stephen Cabral.
Hi, everyone, and welcome back to the Cabral Concept. It's great to have you with me here today. Can't wait to get this week started out right with our Motivation and Mindset Monday show. My favorite way to motivate myself, get myself going, and get my mind right for the week. And what I like to do is share with you a lot of what I'm thinking about, a lot of what I've seen work in my practice, maybe over the past week or a couple of weeks, that are enabling people to move closer to their goals. It's not my job to tell you what your goals should be. Only you should decide on what your goals are for yourself, for your family, your loved ones, your career, etc. What I'd like to do, though, is make it easier for you to attain those goals. Because what I see right now is a lot of people setting amazing intentions for exactly what they want in their life. They know the body they want. They know the career trajectory that they're moving towards. They know the connectedness or the spirituality that they're searching for. They know the health that they want to embody, and they want the relationships which will bring them closer together with others. Because as you start to move through life, you'll realize that life isn't all that sweet if you don't have someone or your close group of people in order to share all of your blessings with. And that's really what it's all about. So what I want to do today, though, is what I believe, and I've spoken about this before, in order to have a great day, you honestly need to start the day off right. Because if you don't, you're always playing catch up. I've given you my morning routine before, but I don't need you to copy my morning routine. It's not about being me or anyone else, and I don't think that people really want that either. You want to be the best version of you. It's when I talk about Ayurvedic body types. The whole point for me talking about Ayurveda and bringing it to people is to respect your uniqueness. Respect your body. Don't use it as an excuse. I hear people say like, oh, well, that's just the way that I am. Well, that's not what Ayurveda is about. And that's not what body typing is about. You want to say, this is my unique prakriti or my unique dosha or my unique body type or genotype, depending on the language that you want to speak. That's all that it is. It's all semantics, right? We say things in different ways, I think, sometimes just to confuse people. But all it is, hey, that's you, but that's the mold you were given. How do you choose to mold you and your life? Because your life is honestly unfolding in front of you every single day. And that's what the last Mindset and Motivation Monday was. It really was. That was episode 1291. It shared the secret that no one ever talks about. And it is, if you go back to that show, you'll honestly find out how you are creating your reality, whether you want to believe that or not. And most people don't, because they don't always like where they're at in life. I don't think that I really liked where I was at in life pretty much all through my 20s. I didn't have it together. I was getting there. I was reading and I was trying to absorb, and I wanted to be there. I wanted to learn. I wanted to master it, but it wasn't all coming together. And I realized that one of the reasons it wasn't all coming together is that you need to do more. And you also can't be afraid of failing. I was still very much a perfectionist in my 20s. I wanted everything to be perfect before I kind of brought it out there to the world, right? And it held me back from writing the books that I wanted to. It held me back from doing more video. It held me back from a lot of things. And it's because I felt like, I think from an ego perspective, that this had to be the best version that people were going to see. Well, I realized that whenever I, you know, brought something out there anyways, I learned more from just bringing it out there, and I had to revisit and tweak it anyway. So the best thing that you can do is simply move forward and don't look at it as failures. I honestly look back at my life, people, you know, when they interview me for shows, whatever, like, what's been your biggest failure? And I'm like, I can't think of one. I've had many, but I don't look at them as failures. I look at them as, oh, okay, that was a great learning experience because I wasn't trying to fail. I was doing something that I thought would get me well, get me healthier, move forward in any area of my life. And it's not that I was trying to fail, and it's also not that it was bad that I didn't succeed in that way. But I didn't give up. I tried, most likely failed again. When I was trying to get healthy, I relapsed and relapsed and relapsed, and it felt terrible. But I wouldn't be where I am today without all those relapses, because each time I learned, and I tried not to repeat the same steps. It's one thing I can say is I try not to repeat the same steps. Sometimes I do, because I'm not perfect. But what I like to do is learn from it and move forward quickly, move forward fast, move forward with energy, and you then recalibrate along the way. Well, one of the ways that you can even start to do that, one of the ways you can even want to move forward in life, is that you have to get that morning right. I want to keep saying evening because there's some things that you should do the night before, and I've done a show on that, so we'll try to link that up today. Today's show is at stephencabral.com/1298. All right, so here's what I want to do. I want to give you 7 tips. I'm not going to make them specific. I want you to then mold them as part of your routine. But these 7 things should be a part of everyone's morning, in my opinion. They really should, because these are things that successful people do, but also healthy people do. I can't give you things that won't also allow you to be healthy, right? Because that is what we need. You have nothing else without your health. It's very difficult, and I don't say that because anyone that's not healthy right now, they say, oh, well, I still have this. You do, but you can't enjoy it to its highest level, in my opinion, if you're always fighting yourself. Like, I was trying to enjoy life when I didn't even have energy, but it was a little bit of a struggle. I was trying to be in a good mood when I had flu-like symptoms all the time with ME, but it wasn't easy because all I was thinking in the back of my mind is, like, my body is aching, I'm exhausted, I have brain fog. Now I know it was my intestines hurt, but my stomach hurt, and it wasn't my stomach, right? Because back then I didn't even know where my stomach was. So here's the thing. We learn, we move forward, but let's get our bodies to their peak. That's what it's all about. Get your body supercharged so that all of these things not only become easier, but you want to do them. And if you want to do them, you'll get success faster in any area of your life. All right, so the first one is this. I want to dive right into these 7, give you a little background with each one of them. The first thing you have to do, when you wake up in the morning, you can brush your teeth first, you can splash a little water on your face, whatever you want to do to kind of get that, what your first thing is that you start your day with. But I need you to hydrate. Your body, think about it. Your body most likely has not had any water for 8 to 10 hours. So if you're in bed for 8 hours and you didn't drink water for a couple hours before bed because you didn't want to get up and have to urinate during the middle of the night, whatever it might be, it's most likely 10 hours. Most people aren't drinking water before bed. A couple people are. Some people are. But most people aren't. So if you think about it, it might even go all the way back to dinner. So you might be close to a half a day without any fluid. Think about that. Think about your cells, your blood, which is your plasma, which is 90% water, your muscles, which are 72% water. They need to be hydrated. If not, what's going to happen? You're going to feel tired. You're going to feel run down. You're going to feel weak. Your muscles are going to burn more. You're not going to feel great. Your brain needs it as well. So we need to hydrate. Now, you can hydrate however you'd like. A lot of people do lemon water in the morning. Some people do lime with a pinch of sea salt and a little water. Some people do what I do, which is the lime, pinch of sea salt, a scoop of the daily fruit and vegetable blend and water. Some people do a little apple cider vinegar and water. Some people do ginger tea. Whatever you like. To me, just make it sure that it's not your morning cup of coffee when you wake up first thing in the morning. And you can go back to previous shows and find out why that is. I'm not saying you can't have a cup of coffee later, just not first thing. And you don't want to do that to what's called your HPA axis in your adrenals and your thyroid. You don't want to do that first thing in the morning. You already have something called the cortisol awakening response. So here's the thing. We want to hydrate our body. How much water? Well, if you're not used to drinking any, start with 6 to 8 ounces. After a while, your body will be used to taking the water first thing in the morning because you won't be used to it in the beginning, right? Doesn't mean it's bad for you. It simply means that your body's not used to that. So you have to get into a new routine. So eventually it could be a glass or 2 glasses, 8 to 16 ounces of water, what your body feels comfortable with. I feel comfortable with about 8 to 10 ounces of water. That's what I drink every single morning. Lime, pinch of sea salt, daily fruit and vegetable blend, shake it up in a mason jar, and drink. That's it. Okay, so that is the first part. You have to hydrate, because if not, all the signals your body might be getting from the headache, the low mood, the tiredness, the irritability, it could simply be because you're dehydrated. The high blood pressure, because you're dehydrated. So get your body some water. Of course, I do my smoothie a little bit later, but we're not even going to talk necessarily about that. What we're going to talk about is making sure that you get hydrated. All right, that's the first thing. The second thing is this. Fill your mind with what you want to start your day. Immediately, I listen to an uplifting podcast or an uplifting YouTube video or something that's going to set the tone for the day. That's it. Affirmations, whatever it might be. But what you need to do is get your mind right because you have the rest of the day. Now, you can start however you want. But I'll tell you this. It's going to be real hard to play catch up. It's going to be very, very difficult to play catch up if you start your day in a bad mood, low mood, irritable, whatever it might be. There's a reason why I wake up 1 hour before the rest of my family. And it's because, let's say that my two young daughters wake up and they're bananas, whatever they might be doing, right? I have to make sure that I'm centered, that I'm good, that I'm not waking up with that. Because if I wake up with that, even though they're amazing girls, they're still kids, then that's how I set the tone for my day. Wake up, quiet time, set the tone for the day. You can read one of your favorite books. That works as well. Anything by Jim Rohn, anything by Tony Robbins, anything by so many great people out there. I can't even understand why I can't think right now. Zig Ziglar, right? So many great people that you can read from. Okay. Dr. Joseph Murphy. There's so many great people to read. And you can just read three pages. Or you can pick up one of those like Maxwell readers and you can read one page out of that book. Whatever works for you. If you're very religious and you want to read a page from the Bible or whatever it might be, that's fine too. But set whatever you do for the first thing in the morning to be uplifting. So if that lifts you up, and if that lifts your spirits, that's what you need to do, okay? That's what it's all about. I would say like tied with this, and I'm doing this basically in order, make sure that you are not checking your email or anything to do with work, the news, all the stuff of the day that you can't be filling your head with first thing in the morning. Because remember, you're waking up out of your sleep. You're waking up out of a theta-based state, which means you're in more of that hypnotic-based state where anything you put in your mind is going to sink in deeper because you haven't put up your defenses yet. You haven't moved to those alpha, beta-based waves. And we'll talk about high beta. I think we've talked about that on some shows. But then you're not going to be able to absorb to the same level. Wait on that. Nobody needs you first thing in the morning. It's really, or if they do, they can't have you at 6 a.m., 7 a.m. They can't. Not yet. Not yet. That's not part of the equation. You need to find balance, and your balance is going to be, listen, I'm going to be a better person for all my coworkers, family, whatever it is, if I get my own 30 to 60 minutes in the morning. So we just need to build that in. And again, if you're not able to do that, time to get to bed a little bit earlier at night. If you're not able to do that, what's preventing you from doing that? Like there's all sorts of different things we have to work through. That's been on another show. All right, now, after you have not checked your email, and you've hydrated, and you've gone over something motivational for you. What I want you to do next is go over just a couple things that you're grateful for. Just a couple things. Maybe it's the same thing every day. I don't want to make this complicated, but would you just give a couple things that you're grateful for? Because there's so much in life that we believe that we need, that we have to have. And that's fine, but if you're always thinking like that, then you're always in a position telling your subconscious mind that you come from a position of lack. Don't come from a position of lack. Those people that come from the position of lack or need or want are essentially repelling that which they do want. So give gratitude right now for what you do have. Feel the feelings of already being fulfilled. And then have the faith and belief that what you are asking for has already been delivered, and it's simply a matter of time. It could happen in an hour from now. That's the belief that we need. But first, we have to give gratitude. What are you grateful for? If you're not healthy, give gratitude for the health that you do have right now, because it could be worse. So you can say, I'm thankful, I'm happy, or you can simply go back to that mantra, every day in every way, I'm feeling better and better. Every day in every way, I'm getting better and better. Every day in every way, I am better and better. However you want to say that, whatever rolls off your tongue, and you say, I'm grateful that I have these opportunities, I'm grateful that yesterday, whatever it is, couple gratitudes, that's it. And in the beginning, it's going to feel very awkward. It was very awkward for me, like, what am I doing? This is so forced. It's ridiculous. Nobody's listening anyways. All of those things went through my head. Pretty normal to do that. After a while, it feels great. I mean, because why? Because you're conjuring up everything you already do have. So it's for yourself. It's for nobody else. Nobody needs to be listening. Hopefully you're up before them anyways. All right, the next thing is this. Now that you've given gratitude, now you can look at your priorities for the day. Now, the reason why I said a successful day starts with the night before is because you have to get everything off your mind the night before so you get a great night's sleep. One of the main reasons people can't sleep is because that mind's always going. Put down your schedule for the next day. Write it all down. My life is scheduled 15 minutes at a time, essentially. It really is. People might say, well, that's ridiculous. That's too busy. It's not. I get everything done that I want to in a day, and then I get home, and I have time for my family. I have time for reading. I have time with my wife. There's time for everything if we schedule it. But events that should take 15 minutes, if they're not scheduled, take 45 minutes, right? So what we need to do is simply schedule our day. If you want to exercise, great, schedule it. If you want to grab lunch with a friend, schedule it. Everything should just be scheduled. And it doesn't mean that you have to be super rigid, but block it in there. Quiet time, scheduled. Do whatever you want in your quiet time. You can read, you can meditate, you can listen to binaural beats, you could get yourself a foot reflexology massage, you could do whatever you want, right? So you can do that, but just put it in your schedule. And you can do your week at a time. If you've listened to my kind of success planning chart from the 12 months to the quarterly to the 1 month to the 1 week into the 1 day, then you know how to implement all of those things. Well, now is the time after you've already given gratitude to move into your list for the day. Because you've already given gratitude, you already know everything so far that you've been accomplishing. Well, now it flows very nicely into this list because guess what? You're in the mindset that all of this is achievable and so much more. But also, it's not overwhelming because all you're looking at is 1 day. People get so overwhelmed at their goals. I was the same way. When you look at your goal, it seems so far away. And sometimes it is. But here's the thing. The truth is, all of your goals come true one activity and 1 day at a time. That's it. Almost nothing comes true all in 1 day, but each day builds upon the other. And next thing you know, you've achieved more in your life. People are looking at you like, how are they doing that? How is it possible that we both get the same 24 hours and this person seems to be living 1 week in a day? And that's the secret. The secret is what we're going through today. And the secret is basically there are no secrets, but there are formulas and there are blueprints, and I didn't create them. I am someone that assimilates information, and then I test it in clinical practice, and then I pass on to you what works. I don't pass on theories. I don't. I pass on what works because none of us have any time, right? We're already dealing with work and family and maybe continuing education or certifications, or we're working on our bodies to get in shape. None of us have extra time, but what we have to do is prioritize. And if we have a formula for doing that, that's how we achieve these things. They do not happen on their own, and they do not happen by chance. Successful people in any area of their life, successful in relationship, successful with their family, successful with health and business and spirituality and their body, none of that is really by chance, right? None of it is. There's a formula that they're following subconsciously or consciously that's allowing them to continue to achieve those results. All right, the next one is this one. This is important for me as well. And I believe it's important for you. You've gone through everything that you need to do. You're hydrating, you're motivating yourself, you're getting yourself ready for the day, you're not checking email yet, you're giving gratitude, you are looking at your day's plan and tweaking it, whatever needs to be done. You have your intentions for the great day you're going to have. And then I need you to take your first step. And here's what I want you to do. I want you to move your body in some way. I want you to boost endorphins to that next level. You will be amazed, absolutely amazed at what jumping on a rebounder, which is just basically a mini trampoline. I did a show on that before on the lymphatic system. For 60 seconds will do to lift your mind and body. No pun intended. Jumping on that rebounder or jumping up and down if you don't have one. Remember, never let what you can't do prevent you from doing what you can do. Some people will say, oh, I can't do that because I don't have a rebounder. Jump up and down as if you're jumping rope. If you don't have the jump rope or can't jump rope, jump up and down. That's it. How far off the ground? An inch or 2 inches. Just get that body moving. You could do my morning exercises if you want. Set of chin-ups, set of bodyweight squats, set of push-ups, set of lunges, set of V-pose with a twist. That's it. I don't do that to transform my body. It helps, but I do that to get the blood flowing. I am literally getting the blood moving through my body, circulating my lymphatic system, and what else am I doing? I'm boosting endorphins. My dopamine levels are going. And again, I'm not doing this to failure, so there's no huge spikes in cortisol. This is to get that body going. My body feels strong after I do that. I feel great. It's now going to be better able to absorb my smoothie, which I'm going to have after this. So that is what I do to supercharge my body. So what did I just do? Well, I hydrated, right? That's for my body and my brain. After that, what did I work on? My mind, by reading a book, by listening to a podcast or watching a video or listening to that video as I'm getting ready, as I'm just kind of prepping. After that, again, I'm not checking. Email does not start until I leave the house. And then what am I doing? Well, then I'm also giving gratitude for what I do have. So I make sure to never forget or come from a position of lack, because when I set my intentions for the day next, it almost looks like a little bit of lack because I'm working towards something, essentially saying I don't have it. But I've already given gratitude, saying all these great things have already come into my life. Why not more? Why not this? Why can't that happen? And I then move right into those actions, which already gives me the self-confidence that it can happen because I've already seen everything I have to be grateful for, right? Really, really important. And then what I'm going to do is I've just worked on my mind, mainly my mind, except for that hydration, but now I'm going to work on my body. And now my mind and body become one. What I've done is I boost those powerful endorphins. I've increased oxygen in my body, because I moved my body. Even if you're just jumping up and down for 60 seconds, that's it. You don't need to sweat. You don't need to do anything. This is for the mind and body connection. I'm pulling everything together, and now I leave the house, or now I'm ready to see my daughters, my wife, because now they're going to be waking up most likely in the next few minutes or so, and my mind and my body is centered. I'm in the right place. I have enough energy for the entire family. I am ready to go. And now I can deal with anything at work. I can deal with anything that comes my way because I have this, essentially this force field, which is, by the way, a real thing. When you look at the HeartMath Institute, you can actually measure someone's energy coming out from their body. It's anywhere from, well, it's about anywhere from 1 meter to 3 meters. Which is a lot, right? That's why you can sometimes feel when you're in someone else's presence. You can also sometimes feel if they're negative. Well, I want my energy to be positive. I want my energy to be exuding with confidence and feeling great. And I'm telling you right now, if you begin to put these practices into play in your life, and again, they're non-specific, drink whatever you'd like, watch whatever motivational thing or listen to it or read it, right? Whatever you'd like. Not checking the email, giving gratitude for whatever you want in your life, whatever's specific to you. Set your intentions for what you do want. Maybe you have a vision board. Maybe you're looking at, you're already feeling that you're there. Then you're looking at your actions for the day that you will be taking, not for the grand scheme of things, but all you have to do today. And then after that, you are going to move your body. You're going to lock in the thoughts that you're having, the feelings that you're feeling, with now the vibrational energy that you literally create as you move that body. When you do that, you will be ready for any day, no matter what it is, a presentation at work, getting your kids up, whatever it is, you will be in control of your life. You've shown your body and mind that you're willing to take control, and that is such a big part of the overall equation. I'm telling you right now, try this for 1 week. That's it. Try this for 1 week and tell me at the end of the week if it's worked for you. I'm guaranteeing you, you will become a new person and you will be amazed at everything that starts to come your way and everything that you're able to achieve once you connect that mind and body. Thank you so much for listening to the show today. It's always a pleasure. Love being able to chat with you each and every Monday on our Motivation and Mindset Mondays. If you want, you can always go back, listen to previous shows. And as always, if this show was helpful, please do feel free to pass it along to anyone else you believe it could serve. Did you know that the body really only becomes sick or imbalanced in only two ways? Over time, you become deficient in vital nutrients, and you also accumulate toxins internally and from the environment. As those nutrients diminish and you increase your total toxic load, your body then begins to show the first signs of dis-ease. It's actually quite predictable, and the good news is that if we know how you began to fill up that proverbial rain barrel, we also know how to empty it to begin the healing process. I was fortunate enough to learn this ancient healing process from my mentor after suffering from debilitating diseases for close to a decade. It was only when I began to implement these techniques did I finally overcome my illnesses and go on to live a life of energy and vitality that I now enjoy. I'd like to share with you now what I discovered after traveling all over the world and how to combine the best of ancient healing wisdom with state-of-the-art science. Allow me to teach you exactly how I've been able to help over a quarter of a million people to empty their rain barrel and begin to transform their body and lives into what they've always hoped they could be. To get your copy of the international bestseller, The Rain Barrel Effect, simply go to stephencabral.com/rainbarrel.